The key ingredient to the success of Channel 7's crime-fighting project, Eyewitness Anonymous, is simply put, you. That is, your awareness of what's going on around you. To help keen that awareness, reporter Dick Johnson brings us this crash course on how to be a good witness.
You're about to witness a dramatization of one of the most common crimes in Chicago and one of the most frustrating to police. They call it the smash and grab. Broken glass, all that's left of a smash and grab. It happens so quickly that the victim usually has little or no idea who did it, and the offender, of course, is long gone. That's why smash and grabs are so common and so frustrating. Now let's replay the incident you just saw in slow motion and see if you can identify the person who did it. In this demonstration, Eyewitness News researcher Yvonne Small was the victim. Because she already knew what was coming, she was probably more perceptive. Still, she doesn't remember much.
It just happened so fast, and glass was flying everywhere, and when I looked, he was gone. He was running, so I saw his back, but that's all. You know, I didn't see what he looked like.
The offender in this smash and grab is a Chicago police officer. In fact, this entire lineup is composed of Chicago cops. With what little Yvonne remembers, she is asked to identify the suspect, just as you would be if you were the victim or the eyewitness.
One thing I want you to understand is a one-way mirror. They cannot see you, but you can see them. Also, they may not have the same clothing on that they had the day that this occurred.
Yvonne was a good eyewitness. She remembered a few outstanding physical characteristics. As it turns out, they were vitally important in solving this case.
I think it might be number two.
Number two. Why did you pick him up?
He's stocky like this guy. He's got bow legs like that guy. I think that's him.
Number two. Okay, we have a positive ID on offender number two. You always want to pick out something that's an obvious characteristic, whether it be an article of clothing or a physical characteristic, a mole, a person's type of speech, or possibly scarring on the face.
As you can see, an accurate description and an eye for detail can be of enormous help in creating a usable picture of a crime suspect. As police artist John Holmes demonstrates, one characteristic, like the shape of an eye, can make a big difference. If we had profiled this crime as part of Eyewitness Anonymous, and if you remembered seeing it happen, then anonymously called in your information to 1-800-73-CRIME, indirectly, you alone may have solved this crime. We hope someday you will. Now, many people have worried about false accusations over the tip line, but you needn't worry. First, the operators are trained to screen out calls that don't seem like legitimate tips. Secondly, the police thoroughly investigate the tips before any action is taken. Now, on occasion, one pusher might turn in another pusher, for example. But as far as the police are concerned, that's one less criminal on the streets. Tim?
Boy, it's hard to imagine with all that glass flying and everything happening so quickly that you could make a real accurate description of the person who...
The first thing the victim's worried about is the person's car, naturally, not the purse. But the way to prevent that is to put the purse behind the back seat or on the floor, somewhere out of view. The smash and grabbers stand there at a street corner at a stoplight and watch a car pull up and try to look in the window to see if the purse is on the seat.
So you can sort of see him craning his neck and casing you the
whole
situation.
Keep an eye out. It happens all the time.
Okay, Dick, thanks. We'll see you tomorrow. Marianne?
Thank you, Jim. The dean of Chicago Alderman says he's ready to endorse a Republican for mayor. We'll have that story and a complete report on a $1 million settlement for a suburban man who lost his leg on the job. We'll be back.
When it comes to absorbency, Viva's more than a paper towel. Watch. To be precise, it's a paper sponge. It may sound incredible, but Viva absorbs as much as this sponge. So Viva can sponge up your sloppiest spills, sponge up your drippiest drips. Incredibly absorbent Viva, the paper towel that's really a paper sponge.
This may look like other tacos, but it doesn't taste like any other. This is Taco Bell's new Taco Light, made with a new light-tasting flaky flour tortilla that lets all the delicious flavors inside come bursting through. Like Taco Bell's meaty ground beef, real cheddar cheese, fresh lettuce and tomatoes. The new Taco Light. A light tasting outside, so you taste more of what's inside.
Ooh, what a difference! Taco Bell! Taco Bell makes
Today, there's a brand new overnight letter, specially designed to meet your most urgent needs. The Emery Urgent Letter. Now you can send 4 ounces up to 20 pages in a full-sized envelope. And the price, desk-to-desk to most of America, is just $11. The more important papers you send, the more you need the Emery Urgent Letter. Meeting America's most urgent overnight needs. Try it.
Another can, Charlie. That's a can?
It's Hefty Steel-Sak, the bag that works like a can.
It's plastic.
It's made of a plastic formula called Linear D.
Linear D.
So strong and punch-resistant, Steel-Sak can hold more than ordinary bags.
Even impossible trash?
Without split.
Without splitting. That's some bag, Charlie.
Strong. Like a can.
Hefty Steel-Sak trash and tall kitchen bags. The bag that works like a can.
Born in a Philadelphia slum, he made his way from a childhood of boyhood pranks to wealth, fame, and happiness. Thursday on AM Chicago, comedian David Brenner. Then on Friday, tennis pro Renee Richards looks back on the battle between Richard and Renee, the two personalities fighting within her, and the final operation which ultimately fulfilled her lifelong dream as Richard the man to become Renee the woman. Join us at 9 for AM Chicago.